Judge just put the brakes on that controversial plan to lease the city's parking operations. Good evening to you. I'm Cherie Palello.
And I'm Mike Dardis. Interesting developments today. Earlier, council passed the plan with a 5-4 vote. WLWT News 5's John London live now to explain what's going on and why the judge quickly stepped in. John.
Well, Mike, the parking plan survived council this afternoon, but now comes the court. Here's a copy of the lawsuit that was filed late this afternoon by several citizens. Judge Robert Winkler issuing a temporary restraining order that effectively prevents the city from implementing the plan they just approved.
Today's debate wasn't as much about leasing the city's 5,700 meters, 1,900 of them downtown, as it was about counting to five. Satisfying Lori Quinlivan about dealing with deficits became paramount.
And I've gotten a lot of my questions answered. And I think in balance, this is a good deal for the city.
To get her to that point of support, a majority of council gave the city manager the freedom to scrap a future police recruit class if need be. That's a turnaround on recent policy. It comes as lawmakers grapple with future deficits once the one-and-done $92 million parking windfall is gone.
Unless we come up with an additional sustainable source of revenue, a large sustainable source, we're never going to be able to plug this hole.
The manager sizes the hole at $35.6 million next year if there's no parking plan, another $10.6 million the following year. But City Hall is still hearing furious dissent and distrust about who calls the shots on the meters.
You know that all of the communities are against this inside backroom deal.
Mayoral candidate John Cranley minced no words about why he supports a lawsuit to try to block the plan.
And there's plenty of ways. If they cancel the streetcar, if they use the casino money, if they use the parking meter revenue, there's plenty of ways they can balance this budget without having to lay off police and fire. And they shouldn't mess up the neighborhoods and try to use fear tactics to raise rates in parking meters and drive business and people out of the city.
All right, now tonight, City Solicitor John Kerp says the city faces legal challenges like this all the time, some of them serious, some of them frivolous. He does not think that a court will interfere with the city's parking plan ordinances, but this TRO states that the city, at least temporarily, can accept no payment or execute any lease pending a hearing in 10 days. Live at City Hall, John London, WLWT News 5.